We're at Royal Palace Wat, which is the largest Buddhist temple in Thailand. It's incredibly sacred space. It's where the royal family comes to worship. And there are all these just amazing temples. There's a school, there's the Royal Coronation Hall. And there's my friend John.
You'll be a professional one day. After train, well trained, and then some restaurant, they have Thai food and also have Thai dancing.
So girls are essentially allowed into the monastery, and what they're doing is practicing to become professional dancers for later on in life. So all around these palaces are these open air pavilions, and they're just lined with like row after row after row of these gilded Buddhas. And there's some text that explains how the Buddha image has changed over time. Either way, they're beautiful, and you really feel like you're in a very sacred space right here. These temple grounds are actually located sort of in the heart of Bangkok, and they just go on and on. You take a look, and there are all these incredible buildings and spaces. I don't know, a couple acres full up. Thailand is a monarchy, actually. There is a king and a queen, and there's a coronation chapel here someplace, and they hold their king and their queen in very, very high regard. And I think it even might be the queen's birthday. You see a lot of these big billboards around that say, God bless the queen, or God save the queen. So this is an amazingly beautiful and gilded room, for lack of a better word, and it's the home of the world famous Reclining Budda. And it's really world famous, and it's huge. There's absolutely no way to get a single picture of the thing. The best we can probably do is its face. It's an open air building, so there's a really nice breeze blowing through here. It's beautiful. Lots of people from all over the world have come to see the Reclining Buddha. So this is probably the best observation point for the entire thing, as good as you can get anyway. And you can see he's huge.